You should now have a general overview of how much water is cycled on Earth, but we haven't yet covered how much water is found where. It's also important to discuss how much water moves from one place to another, as this is how we irrigate our crops and obtain drinking water. We will take a more detailed look at this here. During the course of this video, I will ask you to pause and calculate some numbers, so please be prepared with a pen and paper or an electronic equivalent. This figure is from the textbook, The Blue Planet. And it's a really nice picture of how much water is found where in terms of percentages. You'll notice that some of these percentages are slightly different in different sources. And we want you to focus on the general picture and general amounts. So on a test, if we asked you what percentage of water is found in the ocean, we would accept answers from roughly 96 to 99%. The first thing that should be clear from this figure and the videos that you've seen is that the vast majority of water on Earth is in the ocean. 97.5% in this figure. Pause the video and write this down, then restart the video. Because this water is salty, we can't really use it for watering or drinking. Desalination can be used to produce fresh water from salt water in very dry places, and it's being discussed more seriously as a source of drinking water in places like California, Australia, and the Middle East. The issue is that desalination typically requires a lot of energy to perform, and it produces very salty brine that has to be disposed of. But because water is so important, new technologies are being developed that might make desalination less expensive and environmentally dirty. There's an enormous amount of water in the ocean. This image is found in the NASA article on the water cycle, and what it shows is the Pacific Ocean from space. We are used to images like these, which show land, but you can see that the Pacific Ocean covers nearly half of Earth's surface. California is present in the upper right, and the rest is ocean. When we say that the ocean is salty, we mean that there are many dissolved elements present in the water, and we will discuss these in the ocean section. We will discuss why this is the case and what those elements are, but humans can't consume water with large amounts of dissolved salt, and this will also kill plants. So we need fresh water with low quantities of salt. And the second part of the graph zooms in on the remaining 2.5% of water on Earth, which is all fresh water. We can see from the graph that 74% of fresh water is actually frozen. We will talk about ice and snow in greater detail, but most frozen water is found in ice caps at high latitudes. This includes Greenland and especially Antarctica. Antarctica is one of Earth's continents and is extremely large. It is covered entirely with ice. In some cases, this ice is extremely thick, so this is where an enormous amount of fresh water is found. At this point, we want to calculate the percentage of all water on Earth that is frozen. Pause the video, calculate 74% of 2.5%, write this down, and then restart the video. 26% of fresh water, or just 0.65% of all water on Earth, is unfrozen fresh water. Of this, 98.5% is groundwater, which means water that is found beneath the Earth's surface. Let's pause the video again and calculate how much of Earth's water is in groundwater. It's 98.5% of 26% of 2.5%. We will talk about the importance of groundwater, but it is very important in California and around the world as a source of drinking water and irrigation water. This picture shows the height of the land surface in different years on the telephone pole. This is a real picture taken in Mendota on the other side of the valley, and it shows that the land surface has dropped by about 30 feet over several decades. This is because an enormous amount of water has been pumped out of the ground. This leaves just 1.5% of all fresh water as surface water. This is really what we think about when we think about water. Lakes, rivers, waterfalls, etc. are surface water. This also includes water in soil, the atmosphere, and in organisms. What is amazing is that this represents just 1.5% of 26% of 2.5%. Pause the video and calculate that out, then restart the video. You should see that this is just a tiny, small amount of water. This tells us two things. Number one, there is a lot of water found in the ocean, in ice, and in the ground. And number two, what is really important is that surface water can cycle over and over again. This is emphasized in the videos that you watched and will watch. The idea that the same water has been moving around the Earth for billions of years. So we want to understand this movement.